Happy New Year! Well, hi, I'm Stephen Holt, and welcome to the streets of New York. We're on East 60th Street, and we're going to see a jewel of New York, and we're going to hear from our two great film critics are here, Francis Chervenak and Merrick Bursuk.
Hi.
You look like you just got off the slopes.
I did.
Okay. Francis, you look as cool as a cucumber, ready to give your year's 10 best. And you know, we're going to go into this incredible, we're all native New Yorkers, but did you know about this place, Le Veau D'or?
Doesn't
Le Veau D'or, it doesn't get any better than this. Come on in. Okay. So it's like going back in time being in here, because this is from 1937. Orson Welles used to eat here, and you can imagine how much he ate. I mean, I think this is where he put on all the and Tennessee Williams and Truman Capote and Jackie O, and they haven't changed
all at the same time.
At all, sometimes. Yeah, anyway, you can feel their spirits here today on the Stephen Holt Show. Hey, and let's get going and not predict, but because we know what we like. We're going to talk about our year's 10 best movies. Okay?
All right.
So we'll sit down and we'll...
Parfait, monsieur.
Okay.
Voilà. Bienvenue.
Bienvenue.
Après vous.
Merci. And now we're going to do our year's 10 best. Okay. Francis, what's your number 10?
My number 10 is District 9.
District 9. Okay. I didn't see that. Why did you...
I love the way he used CGI, Neil Blomkamp used CGI, just the way he was able to do a movie about a strong racial allegory using, like, CGI sci-fi.
Okay.
Furthermore, just the graphics, the technology, the world Neil Blomkamp creates was astounding and makes him on par to be the next Peter Jackson, so, hands down, incredible.
Okay, Merrick.
Mine is Me and Orson Welles.
Oh, I didn't see that either. I wanted to. It sounds wonderful.
It's very good. I enjoyed it a lot. I was very surprised by Zac Efron, who plays one of the
yes.
leads.
Yes, you were surprised because... Don't put your hands in front of
well,
your face.
I was surprised because it wasn't the kind of thing I thought... You know, Zac Efron seems like a Disney kind of actor, but he did a really good job. Very, very believable, and I thought he was really good. Claire Danes. And the guy, I forget his name.
Christian McKay.
He's
a friend.
He dead on Orson Welles.
Yeah, he's been doing Orson Welles for years.
Well,
in
he found the role for him, just like the guy who did Truman Capote that time. Remember?
Yeah, it was me. Anyway, yes. My number 10. Okay, this is going to be a very. We're not at La Rue Laurent, we're at the Le Veau D'or, and it's going to be a very foreign year in my list. And I'm starting with The Beaches of Agnes, or Agnes. A beautiful doc by filmmaker Agnès Varda about her life and her life with the other great French filmmaker Jacques Demy, I think his name was, right, who did Umbrellas of Cherbourg.
Yes, Umbrellas.
Beautiful, unusual use of the camera. She's in it herself, narrating her life story. It was incredible and moving. And we're going to move right on to your number 9, Francis Chervenak.
My number 9 is Woody Allen's Whatever Works.
Okay, all right, that one I saw. I like that. I like that a lot. Yeah. Patricia Clarkson, awesome.
It was just, it was great to see Woody Allen doing another New York movie after, I guess it was 3 or 4 years.
Uh-huh.
And also,
yes,
there was just something about the way he was able to show compromise, not as a bane, but more as a necessity that I was really taken aback by. And I felt that it was just kind, but also dealt with some strong adult themes about just oblivion, atheism, and just like the sense of just trying to find whatever works. So I thought
right. I love that film. I actually saw that in Provincetown and I loved it.
My number 9 pick was the Star Trek movie, which I thought maybe Francis might be interested in, and I really liked it. I thought it really moved ahead with the franchise of Star Trek. Some of the recent ones were really not very good at all.
That's true.
The story was great. The characterizations were great. I was so impressed and so surprised.
My number 9 is A Single Man. Okay, the obvious gay choice. Okay. Story of My Life, Christopher Isherwood. I guess it's not any, on anybody else's list. Directed by Tom Ford, the fashion designer. Francis, you're number eight.
Nine,
which we saw together. Yes.
The Rob Marshall Nine, not, yeah, that one.
The musical Nine. Yeah. Nine, the musical with Daniel Day-Lewis. Mm-hmm. Penelope Cruz. Go on, it's your turn.
I was just really taken aback by how it showed the futility in filmmaking where so many people want to create when they fail to at first explore. And I thought Daniel Day-Lewis just handled the creativity of and writer's block themes very well, and just also the immense love story that Rob Marshall was to create with Daniel Day-Lewis, and I guess it was eight other women, which to me was just astounding.
Sounded like a good idea.
How he was able to just blend it and balance it among so many lead actresses. So to me, I was really taken aback by the size, the scope, design, and the story of just filmmaking itself.
Yeah, you
so
really loved it, and I didn't, but I love the women's performances. Well, okay, what was your number?
My number eight, very much on the other side, was The Messenger. I thought was an excellent film.
With that show.
I was very, very surprised here because I wasn't expecting such great work from Woody Harrelson. I tend to have problems with him, but he was excellent
in
this film.
Finest performance.
Finest performance.
Nominated for Golden Globe.
Well, I don't know if that means anything, but he is an excellent, excellent film. Who's the other guy? Ben Foster.
We've interviewed twice on the Stephen Holt show. He's now a friend of the show. Hey, Ben.
I was just totally blown away. I thought it was great acting. Great acting can make even a good film better.
Yes, okay, my number eight is Brothers, which is not on anybody else's list. Okay, it's the story of yet another war-themed film, returning veteran played, I thought, stupendously by Tobey Maguire, comes home to, this is in Afghanistan, and he is imprisoned there under horrible conditions, and it's contrasted with the home life of his wife, Natalie Portman, in her best performance ever, and the brother of Toby, Jake Gyllenhaal, also terrific. Anyway, another powerful, serious war movie. It's a serious year.